attention, ladies. Have you ever noticed that having a crush can actually make you act differently? And some of these over-the-top things we do can actually end up being the demise of that relationship. In my experience as a relationship expert, I've seen so many people ruin potential relationships because they didn't know what they were doing wrong. Today, I'm giving you the top 5 worst types of girls with crushes. And don't worry, ladies, there's no judgment here. We have all fallen into one of these categories from time to time. The point of today is to make us aware of when we're falling into one of those categories so we can stop and prevent that relationship from going sour. If you guys are new to Ask Kimberly, don't forget to hit the big subscribe button down below and come and hang out with me over on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, where every once in a while I come online for a surprise Q&A and answer all of your relationship questions live. You guys don't want to miss these, they're so much fun. Now let's get right into the video. Number 1 is the admirer. Ooh. And I'm not talking about the secret kind, I'm talking about the more blatant kind of admirer. The admirer is not afraid to shower her crush with compliments as a way to initiate conversation or even as a way to save a dying conversation. You got a haircut, it's so nice. These words of praise can be just about anything from his personality to his appearance. Oh my God, I love your new shoes. The problem with too many compliments is that from a psychological perspective, they can come off as submissive. You are like the smartest guy in the school. And compliments can be a really positive thing in certain social relationships and also in relationships where the other person is the leader, like at a job interview or in a classroom. But there is such a thing as going too far, especially in romantic relationships when our goal is to get the other person to like us and see us as an equal. My best advice is that if you really want to give someone a genuine compliment, go ahead by all means, but don't use praise as a filler for actual conversation. Number 2 is the chameleon. Woo! Now the chameleon is someone who's willing to change absolutely everything about herself for the sake of her crush. Now this can include suddenly becoming interested in things that she would never normally do. Oh my God, this novel is so interesting. To wearing an outfit that's totally uncomfortable and not her style just because she thinks that he would like it. Check this out, my crush likes science, so I'm totally learning the periodic table. There's hydrogen and helium, then lithium, beryllium. Phosphorus, then sulfur, chlorine, and argon. Potassium, calcium, so your girl's strong. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, and chromium, and manganese. If you have a friend who's a chameleon, you may have caught yourself wondering, like, what happened to my friend? Like, where did she go? Where is the girl I used to know? Now, people typically become chameleons because they feel that they'll be better liked if they're more similar to the person that they're dating. But ladies, let's not lie to ourselves. A good relationship doesn't come from becoming the person that we're dating. It comes when two separate people have unique talents, interests, and hobbies, and they come together to learn and grow from each other. Number 3 is the helicopter. So if a helicopter parent is a parent who can never leave their kid alone to do anything on their own, a helicopter crush is a person who will never leave their crush alone. They're always hovering around, seeing what their crush is up to, and getting in their face. The helicopter never wants to have her crush out of eyesight for a single moment, and it's consistent. At every school break and every party, the first and only thing she wants to do is look for her crush. You see my crush anywhere? Like, I haven't seen him all day. Where is he? If you have a friend who's a helicopter, she'll always be looking over your shoulder to see where her crush is and what he's up to.
This is a great party. Where's my crush?
And yes, definitely it is important to be in close physical proximity to your crush for a relationship to happen, but people do need time and space to breathe. In this case, quality of interaction is way more important than quantity. Having a few simple, meaningful, and flirty conversations with your crush once in a while and then being off doing your own thing is a lot more effective than just being that weird girl that's always lurking around. When we find ourselves becoming helicopters, usually those relationships don't work out because the crush ends up starting to feel smothered and maybe like we like them too much, which we probably do. Number 4 is the preacher. The preacher is always ready to spread the good word of her crush. The preacher is constantly talking about her crush, what he would do in that situation, what he wouldn't do, how he might feel. And of course, these are all hypotheses because she's not actually in a relationship with this person. The preacher essentially makes out her crush like they're some kind of angel. My crush would never do that because he's such a good guy. Now, you'll know if you have a friend who's a preacher because they will instantly make you feel like the person that they have a crush on is far superior to the person that you like. Oh my god, I love Beyonce's new album, but my crush, he would never do that to me. The problem with becoming a preacher is that it essentially makes you blind to all of your crush's imperfections. You've replaced actually trying to get to know the person they are with creating a fabricated version of them in your mind. Number five is the silent stalker. And don't worry, ladies, this one's the most common of all. The silent stalker is the person who knows absolutely everything about her crush, but she doesn't have this information because he actually gave it to her through talking. She knows it because she's stalked him so much on social media. The silent stalker thrives on checking, checking, and more checking, but never any progressive actions to turn this relationship into a reality. This could go on for years. My best advice is if you do like someone, don't stalk them over social media because it can create a mental barrier that's impossible to overcome. And being relaxed and confident around your crush is one of the key factors to a successful relationship. All right, you guys, if you love this video, give it a huge thumbs up. Come and follow me over on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And of course, guys, subscribe to Ask Kimberly for more weekly videos on relationships. Bye!